Lionel Council for both the parties fairly concede that the present case is squarely covered by the decision rendered in SD Criminal Miscellaneous Part Petition number 2883 of 2014. Rajendra Kabla within bracket 3 of 11 within bracket CRLMP 250 of 2021 versus State of Rajasthan decided on 17-02-2017. The relevant portion of the judgment in Rajendra Kabla within bracket Supra reads as under. This second criminal miscellaneous petition under Section 482 CRPC has been prepared on behalf of the petitioner with a prayer that the sentences awarded to him in 32 different cases for the offense punishable under Section 138 of the Negotiable Instruments Act, details of which are being provided in later part of this order, may be ordered to run concurrently pair. The earlier SD criminal miscellaneous petition number 113 of 2013 prepared by the petitioner before this court was disposed of by a coordinate bench of this court on 16-05-2013. The order dated 16-05-2013 reproduced here under pair. The present petition prior petition had issued checks to various persons. Counsel for the petitioner submits that due to bad financial condition of the petitioner and the circumstances beyond his control, all the checks are bounced and petitioner has been convicted in 32 cases per. In the present petition, clear has been made that sentences awarded in 32 cases may be ordered to run concurrently per. Counsel for the petitioner very fairly submits that as per judgment of the Honorable Apex Court, it is only appellate court or revisional court which can direct that the sentences should run concurrently, and this power cannot be exercised under Section 482 CRPC. Therefore, counsel for the petitioner submits that directions be given to the state government to consider the representation of the petitioner sympathetically. Otherwise, if the sentences are amended to run concurrently, the petitioner shall remain behind the bars for 32 years. After hearing, counsel for the parties of present petition is disposed of in terms of the statement made by the counsel for the state pair. Let petitioner file any presentation to the state authorities for remitting the sentence or ordering that the sentence awarded upon the petitioner in all cases shall run concurrently. In case such a representation is prepared within 2 weeks from today, the state authorities shall take a conscious decision thereupon. Within 2 months, liberty is also granted petitioner to take a recourse to lawful remedy in the case state authorities decline the representation para. The petitioner has prepared this criminal miscellaneous petition claiming that though pursuant to the order passed by the court in SV CRM's miscellaneous petition number 113 of 2013, which wife of the petitioner had already moved a representation of the Chief Secretary of the Government of Rajasthan, but the same was written with a remark that she may move a representation before the Government of India. It is averred in the petition that as the prescribed 2 weeks time for making representation on behalf of the petitioner has already been expired. Therefore, the petitioner is again approaching this court by way of this criminal miscellaneous petition seeking above mentioned really pair. In the meantime, a reference was made to the division bench of this court to adjudicate the following question pair: whether the High Court exercising powers under Section 482 CRPC invoked Section 2427 CRPC and ordered that sentences awarded in two different cases shall run concurrently. The division bench of this court in Arjun Ram versus State of Rajasthan and others within the KBB criminal miscellaneous petition number 1912 of 2013, along with three other miscellaneous petitions reported in 2016 within bracket 1 CRLA within bracket Raj 346, and said the said reference in the following terms of error. As per Section 427 Code of Criminal Procedure, in normal course, a person already undergoing a sentence of imprisonment is sentenced on a subsequent conviction to imprisonment. Such imprisonment commences at the expiration of the imprisonment to which he has been previously sentenced, but the court in its discretion based on settled principles may direct that the subsequent sentence shall run concurrently with the previous sentence. While exercising such discretion, the trial court, appellate court or revisional court, as the case may be, keeps in mind several factors. While examining such factors, the possibility of some error cannot be ruled out. Not only the error, but the absolute non-consideration of the issue about invoking this discretion may also be there, and they may cause great injustice in general. It can be said that every provision of law is meant to impart justice and to ensure fair and objective treatment to which every subject, but while doing so, the chances of causing injustice or failure in extending complete justice cannot be denied. To meet such an eventuality, the inherent powers like Section 482 Code of Criminal Procedure are meant, and those are always open to be invoked to prevent the abuse of process of court and secure the ends of justice. The inherent jurisdiction is having a very large amplitude, but should also be exercised cautiously and only to prevent miscarriage of justice. While keeping in mind that the inherent powers must be exercised sparingly, the court should not restrain itself to invoke the same if any injury is caused to the justice. Well, we are of the considered opinion that to meet the ends of justice and to rectify the gross error, the powers under Section 482 Code of Criminal Procedure can be exercised if court arrives at a conclusion that the trial court, appellate court, or the divisional court, as the case may be, failed in completing the circuit of justice while invoking or not invoking the discretion vested with it as per Section 427 Code of Criminal Procedure. Well, the court, while doing so, must keep in mind all necessary ingredients and precedents which are to be taken into consideration to exercise the discretion as per Section 427 Code of Criminal Procedure. The reference made by Lyman single bench is answered accordingly. Let the criminal misdemeanor provisions be listed before Lyman single bench for their adjudication on merits. Now, in view of the decision rendered by this court in Arjun Ram versus State of Rajasthan and others, Shukla, this decision is again considered for decision of deciding on merits. The facts necessary for disposal of the present misdemeanor petition are that the petitioner was tried, convicted, and sentenced by the different trial courts for the offense of Section 138 of the NI Act, details of which have been given here under. Stop. Thank you. Jai Hind.